do something a little different. I've been plundering through some of my papers, and I had a sealed envelope that I'd mailed to myself to sort of protect this thing. Rather humorous. It's from an online survey that Geico wanted me to do. And right at the time, I was really, fed up with Geico. So about halfway through, I started keeping the things. But they asked me to make comments. So this is my comment. Geico does not give enough reasons for a vehicle that is not driven. There was a time in my life, lived in town, only leave the house when I have to, but would have to drive to Birmingham with my wife or Montgomery or whatever. But, they always give a mileage there that doesn't fit someone that only drives 3 miles a day. And then they base your payments on that kind of thing. Simply keep one tagged and insured for Alabama legal requirements. Sometimes a vehicle is only a backup when the primary vehicle is being repaired or serviced. For instance, one of my vehicles have had insurance and tags so that it could be parked outside my shop. It has not been driven since a month after it was bought due to engine failure. It takes more than $1.298 to repair a vehicle. So you simply have to lay it to the side until your golden goose craps a golden egg. As I can tell you, you can tell I'm aggravated with Geico at the moment and considering changing my insurance company so that I am able to talk to flesh and blood. I doubt if this is even read. I do not have time to call and figure it out. As a matter of fact, I have just made the decision to go to my mortgage insurance provider, State Farm, excuse me, to take care of my needs. Geico has served me well until I needed them the one time in our business relationship. I've owned two trucking companies in the past, and the damn paperwork was easier to deal with than this electronic crap. The only ease of use Geico truly provided me is that I do not have to remember to write a check. I only have to make adjustments to my budget for the sake of all my personal and business needs. Tim Brown, a human and not a lizard, will come to my home. I need to have my home insured updated anyway due to the rise in the value of my home, my shop, etc. Thank you for helping me realize that consolidation is the simplest way to go. State Farm did an excellent rescue a few years back when the hurricane did over $7,000 damage. Signed Reverend Dr. John S. Coleman, a.k.a. claim number. You shall be hearing from me as soon as I make other arrangements. You lizard. Think about it. The next question. To better assist you and future customers, please let us know what information wasn't available. Why should I bother? You're in it for the money. I am overeducated, just love crap mail on my baloney because I count on its perfection. However, I also have changed guaranteed taste, much cheaper and worth it product, but a lot cheaper. That means I can buy more toilet paper by the bulk. Ta-da! You have lost your flavor, which is what you get when you decide to entertain me with an animated, automated slice of my time. Did you know they now have machines that I can click 3 times to get what I really want to see? How do you plan to find information that you are looking for? It gives call Geico, look for an answer on Geico, look for an answer on website, email Geico Insurance, ask a friend, none of the above, other. My answer. Being that you are a lizard machine and don't know that this is a holiday three-day weekend, I will simply leave a voice message and will contact on the date and time I specify. Next question. How can we improve the area of Geico.com that you visit today? What's the point? Lizard does not take into consideration that some people, yeah, that's what we are disabled and our passenger is disabled. That the vehicle that the lizard wants info on only gives you choice and its limited mind can offer. I have never seen a lizard drive anything from a skate to a 40-ton tractor trailer. A lizard has no understanding that sometimes a vehicle is strictly used for transportation of a person who depends on said vehicle because it was brought for that purpose, not to commute, no school, no work, or everything else your lizard provided in its Autobot questionnaire button to click. You know, I was just checking with my past experiences, and I don't believe I ever seen a lizard in a wheelchair, let alone drive a motorized vehicle. I also assume the vehicle is driven at a certain time of day, i.e. day of the week. There's no button that offered that. Only when we have an appointment, no button for that. Also, its poor little mind is limited to 1 mile increments. If I was not disabled and also able to carry my 120 pounds of paperwork back and forth, I would walk the 3 blocks from my home to my business. Also, some days I don't even bother opening up the business. I had was Montbar. It was a secondhand store. I gave clothes away, but I sold certain things to help with the expenses and all. Ended up closing it down because my wife's health got so bad. I had about 200 flip-flops, brand new. I think I was selling them for $1 a piece, but I ended up boxing them all up. And there happened to be a pastor from Africa in the area, and I had him take them, and he cried over it. You know, I'd never met the man. In fact, I didn't meet him later. It was done through my brother. Let's see. Some days I don't eat open up. There I go. I have the authority and power to choose when I want my doors open. But, alas, the poor little lizard is not able to think. It speaks what a bunch of educated idiots think the public will buy. You are only a convenience. But today I got my belly full of being treated like the ignorant child that needs a lizard to help me make a decision. I want to thank Geico for fit ease of payment. It's one-time repair of a vehicle that was wrecked in an accident that was the fault of another. It failed to fight for my $1.98 because it saved money so the lizard could buy him some crap mail. How could we improve your experience? By choices that would allow a person to give an honest answer instead of the closest choice. Close was only good in hand grenades and horseshoes. You know, I bet that anyone that works within the corporate offices even realize that when two semis, one going one direction and the other coming another, have ever thought that those two drivers, when they pass each other on a two-lane, non-upgraded to legal U.S. standards, have come 18 inches close to death when they pass? Oh, I'm so sorry. I forgot a lizard does not think. Thank you for choosing Geico. I just thought that was a little funny. I don't know. Maybe I'm wasting my time. Really, I'm trying to learn how to work this computer. Back when I had XP and I had the finest video making equipment, it was good. At a point around 2005, maybe sooner, I'd have to look at my paperwork. I've done blogs on online here and there. I can't even find them. Concerning my experience with my wife in the hospital and, you know, what was going on. But I just wanted to, you know, see how this goes, see if y'all have a laugh or two. I am Reverend Dr. John S. Coleman, Doctor of Divinity. I sort of joke and say that DD after the end of my name is dumb, because I am nothing. I am nothing without the Spirit of God directing me. And believe me, that is a bicycle that can be stressful at times. I love all of y'all that I come in contact with. God and I, we sort of like this. He got me wrapped around his little finger. Got it hooked in my jaw like an open fish. But I go by the name of Bad Habit. That's been my handle since 1974. And maybe one day I'll tell you that. But they call me Big John, Bad Habit, or JC. The only people that call me Doctor is of an MBA. I enjoyed it. I hope you did.